Welcome to Power Electronics Lecture Series. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you cycloconverter in this session. So to understand cycloconverter, these are my session outlines, where first I'll explain basics of cycloconverter. After that, we will see what is the need of cycloconverter in power electronics. After that, I'll explain you classifications of cycloconverter. Then after, we will see step up and step down types of cycloconverter with its basics. And then after, I'll explain applications of cycloconverter. So this is all about cycloconverter with my session with these outlines. So let us begin this session with basics of cycloconverter. So see, cycloconverter, that is AC to AC converter. And in cycloconverter, we don't use any DC link. So here we convert AC signal into AC signal without using any DC link. So our agenda is to convert frequency. And from name itself, we can understand cyclo means what? Frequency. So cyclo means frequency. And here in cycloconverter, we change frequency. So here our agenda is to change one frequency into other frequency without using any DC link. So cycloconverter is AC to AC converter without using any DC link. So it converts AC signal of fixed frequency to AC signal with variable frequency. So there are many applications where we need to change frequency. So by using cycloconverter, we can change frequency without using any DC link. There is one more way where we can change one frequency of AC into other frequency of AC, but where we can convert that AC into DC and DC to other AC frequency, which is very bulky. But here in cycloconverter, we don't use DC link. We directly convert one AC signal to second AC signal. It is also referred as frequency changer, as our agenda is to change frequency. This conversion is done by switches like thyristor and controlling mechanism of it. So in future, I'll explain you many cycloconverter, different types of cycloconverter, where we will be using switches, where as a switch we will be using thyristor, and by controlling thyristor sequence we can convert one frequency into second frequency. So all those things in future I'll explain you step by step. See, if you say this is a cycloconverter, then at input side we'll be having AC signal with fixed frequency with fixed voltage, and at output side AC signal with variable frequency and variable voltage output will be there. So ultimately our agenda is to change frequency. So there are two things which we can do. One is by increasing frequency, we can use cycloconverter, and second is by decreasing frequency, we can use cycloconverter. So all those things that we will see it step by step. So first, I'll explain you need of cycloconverter. The cycloconverter can be used to control speed of motor. Here you will be observing there are different types of motor. Some motors are having higher load handling capacity, and some motors are having lower load handling capacity. So by changing frequency, we can control speed of motor. If motor is functioning with higher load, then there are so many parameters by which we can control speed. One is frequency. So if frequency is been reduced, in that case we can drive heavy load. Like, see, if I consider one motor over here, and if I have less frequency with higher voltage, in that case we can drive heavy load, as heavy load cannot be handled at higher frequency. So sometimes we need to reduce frequency, and that we can do it by having cycloconverter. In some applications we need to increase frequency to drive light load. So if you have light load and if you want to handle that fast, in that case we can increase frequency, and that could be done by using cycloconverter. So we can handle light load by increasing frequency and heavy load by decreasing frequency. So this is how we use that in motor. We can use this extensively for some applications where motors are used, like rolling mills, cement, water pump industries. So there are many applications. At last, I'll show you so many applications where we need to drive motor with different ratings. So in industries, that is very essential to control speed of motor with different rating, and that is where cycloconverter plays important role. So let us see the classifications of cycloconverter. One classification of cycloconverter can be done based on operation frequency. So if we increase frequency with respect to input frequency, then that will be step up cycloconverter, and if we decrease frequency at output with respect to input frequency, then that will be step down cycloconverter. So based on output frequency, we can classify that as step up and step down cycloconverter, where in step up cycloconverter we increase frequency at output side, and in step down cycloconverter we decrease frequency at output side. Based on input phase and output phase, again we can classify that in three domain, where there will be one phase input and one phase output cycloconverter. There could be three phase input and one phase output of cycloconverter, or there can be three phase input and three phase output of cycloconverter. So based on input and output phases, we can classify that in three domains. So this is how we can classify cycloconverter. Now I'll show you some basics of step up cycloconverter and step down cycloconverter. So let us discuss basics of step up cycloconverter first. So as I have explained earlier, step up cycloconverter is a cycloconverter where we increase output frequency compared to input frequency, and it is not used widely in many applications. Why? The reason is, in India and in USA, most of the applications are working with frequency less than 60 hertz. So if you use step up cycloconverter, then we will be increasing frequency, and if you increase frequency above 60 hertz, then there are not many applications. So as there are not many applications, this step up cycloconverter is not widely used in practical applications. Step up cycloconverter requires force commutation, and as you need force commutation of thyristors, which is used in cycloconverter, it increases the complexity of circuit. So for low power handling applications, we use cycloconverter. For high power handling applications, we don't use cycloconverter, as it requires force commutations, and in step up cycloconverter frequency will be higher, and not many applications are there, but low power applications are there where we can use step up cycloconverter, and in that we need to have forced commutation, which increases complexity of the basic circuit. Now when we talk about step down cycloconverter, then as per the name, we can say frequency at output side will be lower than the frequency at input side. So in step down cycloconverter, output frequency will be less than input frequency. It is mostly used in different applications. Why? The reason is, step down cycloconverter that has been used to degrade frequency with respect to input frequency, and many practical applications are there where we have frequency lower than 60 hertz, we can use step down cycloconverter, and in that we don't need force commutation. So step down cycloconverter requires natural commutation where we don't need forced commutation. So by decreasing thyristor current below holding current, we can commute that. So natural commutation can turn off thyristors. That's why this is mostly used in industries, and it is easy to build up with and easy to operate even. Why? The reason is, it requires natural commutation, so you don't need additional circuit to commute thyristors which is connected in circuit. Many step down cycloconverter is available with different applications. Single phase to single phase cycloconverter, three phase to three single phase cycloconverter, and three phase to three phase cycloconverter. And all those cycloconverter that we are using it with heavy industry motors, where we are dealing with to operate with very heavy load, in that situation we should use step down cycloconverter to drive motor with heavy load. Now let us see the applications which is there with cycloconverter. We can use that in cement mill drives, we can use that in rolling mills, we can use that in water pumps, we can use that in washing machine, in mine vendors. Many industrial applications are there. And if you observe all those applications, then you'll be observing load is very heavy. And as heavy load has been there, we need to decrease the frequency. And decreasing of frequency has been done by using step down cycloconverter. So there are many practical applications of step down cycloconverter. And if you have applications where we need to handle lower power with motor, in that case, we should increase frequency by using step up cycloconverter. So I hope that you have understood this session. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future, I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.